Hello everyone, in this video we're going to learn how to switch the order of integration in order to solve a double integral successfully. So if you're dealing with an integral like this, a double integral precisely, so x from 0 to 1 for example, and y from the y from 0 to 1 and then x from y to 1. Okay, and then the function would be ex squared dx dy. Notice that you can't evaluate this integral as it is because you can't evaluate with respect to x ex squared, right? Because if you try to use u is equal to x squared doing the substitution, then the du will be 2x, okay? But there's nothing in the part of the du, there's no x here, right? X to the first power, we're missing it. So as a result, we have to switch the order of integration. In other words, we have to make sure that the first integral deals with the x, okay, with respect to x, and then the second integral, the inner integral, has to deal with respect to y, right? So we're going to switch dx and dy. But first, before we do that, let's draw a picture, okay, an xy plane, basically. And notice that here in the inner integral, the limits are from y to 1, right? And these are the limits for the x values, okay, over which we'll be integrating. So the y goes from 0 to 1, so let's label the points 0 to 1. Okay, so that's 1, this is the origin, 0. And the x values go from y to 1. Okay, so let's get 1 here, that's the point for the x, the upper limit. And the lower limit for the x is y, okay? Equation x is equal to y. What is the equation x is equal to y? It's a straight line, right? That meets at the point 1, 1. Okay, 1, 1. And this is the equation x is equal to y. Okay, so basically we're interested in this region. Okay, well, let me write the equation here, x is equal to y, and we're dealing with this region. So now, to switch the order of integration, like we said, we're going to switch the integrals, and we're going to make, instead of making 0 to 1 for the y, we're going to make 0 to 1 for the x. Okay, so we're going to have 0 to 1 for the x, okay, and now for the y, we're going to have from 0 to the equation x is equal to y, okay? So notice that x is equal to y can be also written as y is equal to x, okay? So from the y limits are from 0, the x-axis, to the equation y is equal to x, okay? So y goes from 0 to x, in other words. Okay, so you see how we switched the order of integration, and now we keep the same function as it is. And now, the last thing that we will switch will be the dy with the dx, right? Before we had dx dy, but since we switched the integrals and appropriately changed the limits, we also have to switch the thicknesses, right? The order of the thicknesses, dy dx, right? So before it was dx dy, now it's dy dx. Because the first integral was done with respect to x now, because we went from 0 to 1 for the x, okay? And for the y, we went from 0 to x. The equation y is equal to x, right? And that deals with the y integration. Okay, that's why the dy comes as an inner integral and the dx comes as the outer integral. So now it will be easy to evaluate this integral. So let's do from 0 to 1 and we're going to evaluate the first integral. So the first integral, let me do it separately here. And remember that when you do the first integral, ex squared will be the constant, okay? So you're basically dealing with this integral. You're putting the ex squared outside because it's a constant, and then you're dealing with the dy, okay? So this is the integral that you're talking about, so the constant remains there, ex squared remains there. And then, as you know, basically what this is that you're going to have a y to the zeroth power, right? Because the y to the zeroth power is 1. So now, as you know, when you're taking the integral, you have to increase the power of the y by 1, okay? And also divide it by that power 1, okay? And this will be evaluated from 0 to x. Okay, so as a result, ex squared is a constant, stays there. And then y is evaluated from 0 to x, so we take the upper limit, substitute it for the y, and then subtract the lower limit from that, substituting it in the y as well. So that's going to give us ex squared times x, or simply ex, ex, ex squared. And now this will be put in the second integral. Okay, so this will be now x ex squared dx. Okay, so now you're dealing with one integral as a result. And notice that you can use substitution now, because you can have u is equal to x squared, and du will equal 2x. Okay, and notice that the limits for u are going to be the same as for the x, even if you were to change your limits and the variables, the change of variables is still going to be the same limits from 0 to 1. Okay, because when x is 0, u is 0. When x is 1, u is still 1, right? So from 0 to 1 for the u. But let's work out the substitution. So we're going to have e to the u. Okay, well, let me write the ex squared. So x squared is the u, okay, and then the 2x that you're going to multiply it to is going to be the du, okay? But notice that the du is 2x, but originally we didn't have the 2x, we only had the x. So to get rid of that 2 that appeared, that constant 2, the coefficient, we have to have a 1 half multiplied, right? Because that 2 did not exist there before. Right, so as a result, let's separate that because this is separate work. As a result, we will have a 1 half, so we're going to keep that 1 half, and we're going to substitute now the x squared with the u, so it's going to be e to the u du, right? Because 2x, well, du is 2x dx, right? So we shouldn't forget the dx. So so du takes the dx with it. So, as a result, the limits are still going to be from 0 to 1, which is convenient. And then we're going to evaluate that, as you know, the EU, the integral of EU, is still going to be EU, right? So it's going to be EU evaluated from 0 to 1. So that's going to give us e to the first power minus e to the zeroth power, right? Because you substitute in the limits, the upper and the lower limits, for the u here, inside the u. So as a result, this will give you 1 half e to the first power minus 1 half. Okay? Because e to the zeroth power is 1, right? So 1 half times e to the 1 is 1 half times 1 half e to the 1 minus 1 half times 1, which is 1 half, negative 1 half, right? So this is your answer for this particular integral. So I hope that you've learned how to switch the order of integration in this video. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.